Bag fuel, baby.
When did you realize in this music business it was just more than making good music? Because Esso and I, when he had to introduce me, because you know I've been in the industry,
yes, sir.
But he had to introduce me to what the machine is like. Ooh. When did you get that wake-up call? Or because there's guys that we know that still think, you just make music, and it goes like that.
I go through it with my artists. So let me just answer the first question first. I realized that it was bigger than music, I want to say 3 years ago, right? Mm. Actually, no, I'm lying. 4 years ago, accepting it, I realized this is too funny, slap. Right? All right. Because knowing is one thing, but accepting it, right, was another, right? So I dropped Wait A Minute, right? This is 7 years ago, right? So 7 years ago, Wait A Minute dropped, had a 2 year run, right? 2 year run was just like
immaculate. That's immaculate. One song.
That's immaculate, right? So now I'm going, okay, cool. Why am I running in place? I felt like I was running, I wasn't growing. More people, the notoriety was, but I wasn't growing, just the relationships that other people were developing and doing. So I'm like, wait, damn, like what? Why I'm not, you know, I have a bigger record than. I didn't understand relationships. I didn't understand, yeah, relationships, man. You know what I'm saying? Because, and misogyny's relationships. I just thought, okay, if I can make music, good music, then I'll be fine. So I didn't take the time out to go on certain studio sessions and make records with certain producers because I was just like, I got a different kind of sound. I didn't know that you kind of like had to build with the top tier producers and et cetera. I just felt like the money, the cost wasn't worth it. But then later you realize, like, hey, you know what? It would have been worth it. But relationships, man, I try to teach my artists now about that, relationships and about being outside, out of sight, out of mind. And and you gotta build, man, because it's not just about the music, man. It's totally not. This game is like kind of like 10% music, 90, you know, relationships and things like this. It's weird though, because it's the music business. So you like, damn, if I just make music, I got one of the dopest artists right now, man. I gotta say it, man. You know, and I just was in the office the other day talking about this, right? I got one of the dopest artists in New York City right now. His name is Cocky Kai.
That's my guy.
Let me tell you something.
That's my guy.
If you know talent. He nice.
You met him before us.
Fat kid with braids, man.
He nice.
Talent? Oh, my Lord. No. Talent, man. He does it for me. I mean,
you've been with him for a minute.
Everything, right? For 2 years we've been running. It has been everybody to Meeks, the voice, you name it, taps in with this guy.
Yeah.
But everybody, because they looking for, he's not as clouded up as the rest of the guys.
What you mean by clouded?
Oh, clouded up. I mean, clout.
Oh, clouded. My bad.
I'm sorry.
I thought you said clouded.
Oh, no.
My bad.
He's not as
clouded up.
He doesn't have the clout that they have, but the talent, he's running circles around them.
Yeah.
But they'll take longer to sign him and put something and do something behind him because they're waiting for that. They're waiting for, and I'm going, damn, you know he good. You know he good. You could just make one move and we could do.
What do you think is the issue, S?
I'm going to say, like, Nick, we got to understand this. When I started doing this, a certain person told me, market myself and look at myself like I'm a rapper.
Totally.
Right? So when you do that, it's levels to how you got to move up.
Yes, sir.
Right? I chose to say, yo, we're going to build a foundation. We could have came out and got Phresher's Clues, this one, that one.
Yes, sir.
I said, but I ain't do this. I got to build my way up. So I built my way up. Then I got to another endorsement level. We got the Hot New Hip Hop.
Mm-hmm.
Then I built myself up. Then I got to eight at the Table. That was another endorsement.
Yes, sir.
After I did that, then I got to My Expert Opinion. That was another endorsement.
Yes, sir.
Now he's producing the show and he's the cameraman of the show that I'm doing with Clue. We just did Little Baby the other day. From all of those different things, although My Expert Opinion is a cultural show that everybody knows us from, people are trying to give me shit just from seeing the BTS.
Yes, sir.
From me, Clue, and Little Baby. So everywhere you go, you get endorsed to a higher level. So if this rapper, like your man, is just sitting there saying, I'm super duper talented, where are you super duper talented at? On your own shit? The talent for us is, like I tell people, is the talent is if I say, Phresher, I need you to write a record for Ghost, and I need you to do one for yourself.
Totally.
and I need a hook for this nigga, and I need you to be on a pop record with Neo.
Yes, sir.
That's talent, right? And in order to do that, you got to mix and merge with all of these people. One person is going to take you to the next level. So I would want to see your man, if I'm in the building,
yes, sir,
and I'm doing what's going on right now, I want to see your man swerving with some people.
And
you know what I'm saying? I need to see him on records.
This is my biggest thing with him now. Mm-hmm. I tell him, listen, doing all these records by yourself ain't gonna do anything for you. You gotta mix and mingle. And this is why I was in the building. And I'm just here like, yo, look, this is what I do, but I also write. I do everything.
Okay.
Because you gotta increase your value. You understand? So it's not about it's about what you can bring to a table. So if I'm going in here and I know that you care about Joe Schmo, I got something for Joe Schmo. And that's what every artist needs to understand. It's not about you do what you need to do so you can do what you want to do. You understand? And that's been my toughest teaching, but that's been my strongest point to them. Listen, everybody not going to care about you. But you know what? I go in there like, yo, I go in these rooms so funny now because I learned it, the game. I go in like, yo, what you got going on? What do you care about?
Mm-hmm.
I need to know what you care about so we can talk about what you care about and how I can bring, I can strengthen that right there. I'm going to talk about what I'm
doing. I got a real question for you.
Let's go, man.
One, I know you fucking with some young dudes.
Yes, sir.
One, their frontal lobe is probably not developed.
Yeah, totally.
And when you first came through, do you think you was receptive to hearing things that you're saying? All right. So my thing is, how the hell you gonna get through to them?
This is what I'm saying. I
think the best bet, and I've always said this with young dudes, it's only a fair amount. He's an exception. He's a young dude that didn't need to see to listen. He just heard the words.
I had my father, so I had to listen.
Yeah, but young dudes, they gotta see it.
Yo.
So I used to tell him, tell niggas your resume. And he'd be like, no.
I don't want nobody.
So when you're talking Phresher, yes, I'm like, is Phresher showing what he had to go through to make things happen with Eminem? Is Phresher showing what he had to go through running through these New York streets with all the other young niggas that's coming up? Because you're still young.
Yes, sir.
You know?
Let me tell you something. Mm-hmm. Let me tell you something.
Yeah.
I know they say experience is the greatest teacher, right? But if 10 motherfuckers fall in this hole right here, right? Why would you want to be the 11th one, right? And I know you say, yo, I ain't them. That's what the average person would say, right? Right? But I'm trying to teach my dogs, right? So I try to find a balance in between letting them learn on their own. But I tell them all the time, I said, I can't kind of be here for the learning experience because, damn, it's my time. I got time I got to give to my daughter, my son, my wife. So when I go over here and I spend all this time and energy with you and I decide to call up this DJ to tell him play your song on the radio versus mine, I don't have time for you to do that. So this is what you want to do? I'll come back. And that's when I scare them up. That's when they like, you know what? Because they don't want to. I'm telling you, I am a great asset. I'm not even going to undermine it. No, I'm going to talk my shit. Because when you know, my dog, I got Drewski tell me all the time, yo, bro, you know what? He said, yo, bro, every time you call me, it's about everybody but yourself. In this industry, they would tell you, don't really deal with artists because they're going to be about themselves. And I'm so the opposite. I know what I can do. If a snap of a dime, I know I can.
But you got executive hat on right now.
Yeah, totally.
So you changing.
Yes.
But that's my question.
Yes.
Because now we and them are going to look at you differently.
Yes, sir.
We're not going to look at you as a rapper, guiding. We're going to look at you as somebody that's either starting a label,
yes,
trying to guide young people.
Mm-hmm.
So we see you differently. And I'm sure that they do too. It doesn't matter about your age. It matters about your position that you're in.
Mm-hmm. Totally.
So sometimes they put those roadblocks up because now they'd be like, yo, Phresher, he's a business nigga now.
Yes, sir.
That's how
he on TV.
Yo, it don't even gotta be on TV. He's not creative. He's a businessman now. So maybe I'm looking at him like a businessman because what he's saying to me is I've explored this being a rapper and I've had great success.
Yes, sir.
But I can see it's more success on the other side.
Yes, sir.
I can have more time to myself.
Yes, sir.
I'm not at the whim of everybody else, and I can let y'all go out there, and I could make money.
Yes, sir.
I'm going to be a producer of artists,
yes, sir,
in New York City,
yes, sir,
right? But yeah, they're gonna recognize that
because
totally.
So they're gonna relate to him differently, not like a creator.
Let me show you something.
So how you break that wall down?
I'm gonna show you
I'm right after you. Go.
Yeah. How do you view Phresher as right now?
As an executive, that's how I see.
Okay,
it. But I didn't know him prior. We only talked a couple.
No. Now, how do you view 50 Cent
as an executive?
Totally.
You know how I was taught to view him? As a television star. See, we came up from Get Rich or Die Trying.
Mm-hmm.
So when I was up at This Is 50 and people would be in shock, the first thing they would say is, he's on TV.
Mm-hmm.
He's a television star. And it fucked my head up. Because I'm like, it's still boo-boo. That's
exactly.
And you know what I mean. But you see him as an executive now. I still see him as a television star.
I grew up with him. So it's seeing, my thing is, like he spoke, there's no limits to people. So my mind is, I see them who as they are at that moment.
Yes, sir.
Things are ever changing.
Yeah.
Some people that watch this game, they just get locked in on where they meet them. They don't pay attention to what they did in the past.
Yes,
they don't pay attention to what they're going forward. That's them.
Yes,
but
sir,
how I see it is every step of the way, he was a rapper. He still might rap.
Yes, sir.
But I don't look at him as a rapper.
Because
he has a podcast.
Yes,
he's developing. Yes, people, sir. He's doing other things.
Yes,
so that I'm not, I don't put people in a box of where I meet them. Like, for example, let me just say this. Ghost don't know this. We was talking, and I said, yo, with the show with me and Clue, I said, yo, a lot of these guests, we can also have them on BagFuel. It makes sense because
totally.
They'll be talking
listen
about-
listen to what he's about to say.
And they'll be talking about something totally different. But they'll say, yo, S, you just interviewed me with Clue. And
Who?
I said, all right, well- I'm going to produce the BagFuel shit and Ghost and Hynaken can interview them then.
Ghost didn't even know.
Real
shit,
about?
We spoke about that.
This makes it real different.
Yo,
so
man.
I can be behind the lens. I'll call somebody else and be like, yo, you sent it right?
Mm-hmm.
Yo, go, because it makes sense.
Yes,
because
man.
He can also do that.
Yes.
Other people would look at him and say, yo, he's just doing the camera. No,
no,
this is one thing he does.
Yeah.
I like
he does
that.
Other things.
I like
he's
as,
on the microphone.
Well. And I